In today's video, we will be starting off a new KSP science game, heavily modded with remote tech, with open planets, with beautiful visual enhancements, including parallax and more. Stick around, this is gonna be fun. So hello, hello everybody, I'm your host GrunfWorks, and we are starting, as I said, a brand new save. And in this playthrough, we will be playing with heavily modded, and I will be sharing my mod list in the comments below. Just a few mods that I will be playing as a note. One of them will be the Kerbal Construction Time, which you can see me right now spending some upgrades. So this is one will ensure that all the construction takes time, the research takes time, which makes also time of an issue. So I will be playing with a lot of difficulty introduced by the mods and all that jazz. So one of them will be the Kerbal Construction Time. The other one will be the remote tech, where probes need to be controlled. And this is all controlled by a huge community tech tree that you see in front. And it starts with probes before crew, meaning that you have actually first to go with probes and then onwards to different crew programs. And to make it more interesting, I'm playing with Outer Planets mod. Yes, Outer Planets is amazing mod and I love it. It introduces the Sarnus, Elu, Slate, Tecto, basically Saturn, all of its moons, you know, Urlum, Neda, and all others, and it will be fun. And to top it off, we will be playing with our YouTube members and Patreon. So, Joey Kerman, you are a pilot. We will be assigning you this beautiful suit that you can see here, actually, as a scientist. Smoking Kerman is also a scientist, so we will be actually giving you a different suit. Kiltless, who is one of my top patrons, he will be getting another, basically, SpaceX suit. Dan, who has been my longest supporter, will get a really cool legacy suit, and he will be an engineer. And Stian Kerman is my first and only YouTube member, and he will be getting this ultra cool blue suit. So if you want to get on my roster, be sure to check out my YouTube membership program or a Patreon that you will be, link will be shared in the description. And you might get yourself one of these named Kerbals and be part of my adventures in the solar system. All right, so without further ado, let's get into things. We obviously need to start somewhere, and first we need to test our probe. So we're gonna take this Stay Putnik, and we need to put some science on it. So we're gonna be gathering this initial science by putting the thermometer and press barometer, and obviously since it's controlled by remote tech, we need to have antenna, because without antenna, power and connectivity, you cannot control the probes. So yeah, this is gonna make a game a lot harder, and I love it. I love playing with remote tech. It introduces so much complexity, so much, makes things so much more challenging. So we have constructed our first probe and added to the queue, so it's gonna be built. So now I'm building the first small probe rocket that I will be just launching to get this initial science when flying low. So the idea is get this probe, launch it off, and immediately as it shoots off, we will be conducting experiments and transmitting them back. Yeah. See, really simple, really, you know, minimalistic probe, but it just will help us to get this initial kick. I'm gonna put all gathering science on an action group so that I can actually quite quickly gather it and then send it back home to, you know, Kerbal. Right, test probe. It's not gonna be test probe, it's gonna be sounding rocket one. All right. The description, our first sounding rocket, because I'm so proud of it, how it's, what it is and what has become. So as you can see with Kerbal Construction Time, it takes a while until it gets built. And guys, please do let me know in the comments below if you like this and if you don't mind seeing this. Okay, so we are now on the launch pad and we need to quickly conduct our experiments. Log the temperature, save it, log the pressure data, save it, and telemetry, save it. We're not gonna send it, but we're just gonna recover the vessel because the vessel is going nowhere and we have gotten 12 science. That 10 of those, which we will use to unlock the batteries, because batteries we need. Batteries are storing our electricity, and without electricity, there is no communication. Henceforth, no ability to basically, you know, transmit the data. So, As you can tell, we have unlocked the batteries and the solar panels, but we're gonna be putting two batteries on the sounding rocket 1B. And I have added the sounding rocket 1B for batteries, add to the queue. Right. Okay, so those two are now getting built, our first sounding rocket and the first sounding rocket with batteries. We'll see if it makes any changes. Now, let's roll it out to the launch pad. And I thought about cutting all the details from this build list, but I think it's kind of interesting to show a little bit. There it goes, a rocket. Look at it, how proud. Yeah, okay, it's doing the flippies. Okay, let's transmit the experiments. Oh boy, we don't have any electric charge, so we cannot transmit the experiments, which means we just wasted a perfectly good rocket. Also, we've noticed that it flipped. We could actually spin stabilize it, and I'm just gonna do that on this next rocket, so that we're gonna be building. So I'm gonna tilt these fins slightly, and we're gonna call it Sounding Rocket 1C Spin Stabilized. Good. Save it, and we're gonna add it to the build queue. Right. Okay, we have also unlocked some upgrades which we're gonna put, and let's roll out the battery powered one to the launch pad. Let's see if it goes any better. Okay, and of course stability is lost, but since we do have the batteries, look at this, we can transmit the science, and in the top left corner you can see that we have connection, indicated by the green, now turning red, marker as the rocket splashes. Doesn't matter, we have 19 science, which means we can unlock basic rocketry. Basic rocketry or basic aviation? I'm actually gonna go for the basic rocketry. It's gonna give me a lot more parts that are gonna help me construct more and better rockets. Okay, now we're waiting for the spin stabilized rocket to be built, and also I'm gonna use my upgrade points to be able to go further. Now, with general rocketry, we have unlocked the bigger booster, the shrimp booster. And as you saw, we were able to transmit the data from flying low. So immediately when the rocket launches, we were able to transmit science low. Now we're gonna go for the science high. To do that, we need to be, I believe, above 17 kilometers in altitude, meaning this probe has to have a bigger booster, which we are just now putting. And we need to have a little bit more batteries so that we have enough oomph to basically hold this stabilized and all that jazz. Right, then we need the communitron, which would be the antenna of choice to communicate back and transmit the data. Then we want to put fins, and remember, taught by previous experience, we want to turn them slightly so that it's spin stabilized. We don't have SAS units yet, so spin stabilization is the thing. Okay, let me just make sure that I put everything on the action group, and then experiments. Maybe I'm gonna use the action group, maybe I won't, but I make it that my point to always have action groups if I need to do things quickly. Usually when things spiral out of control is when you want to do things quickly, so hands full. Alright, putting the spin stabilized rocket now to the launch pad, and we're gonna go for launch. 3, 2, 1, and ignition. Okay, looks decent enough. It starts to spin, and will it flip? Nope, it won't flip. See? Now it's going nice, straight and true. Probably I should issue an epilepsy warning here because, yeah, it gets a little bit spinny, but it doesn't matter. What we now can do, we can in peace and quiet do the experiments, but apparently I already managed to succeed them to do them on my previous one, which means this rocket is just for validation of the spin stabilization procedure. Good. Okay, fair enough. Let's remove this and enjoy this probe as it plummets back down to carbon. So there we go. It's going downwards. All right. And cutting through a little bit of unnecessary fluff, we can see our rocket as it descends all the way down to the ground level. Bye-bye. Fortunately, we have 10 science, which means we can unlock now the basic aviation part. We're gonna warp it so that we actually get the basic aviation tech unlocked, and that will help us construct more and better rockets. Now, if you remember, we took this small one and we're gonna make it a two-stager now. So the two-stager will actually secure us that we get to space. At least that's the plan. So it's gonna be spin soil rocket 1E, two-stager to space. Right. So as you see, I'm gently and slowly milking the science as much as I can. I'm not min-maxing anything. I just want to take time and actually enjoy playing with the remote probes, with remote tech and stuff. I hope you guys like it. Which reminds me, if you really like this video, do please share, and if it's interesting to you, please share a like, give me a like, and it helps me gauge how much you guys are interested in the video. So yeah, that's it. All right. There we go. So what we have now is we have a two-stager sounding rocket that will hopefully get to space, and we needed a bigger antenna because we will get out of range of this small reflectron rocket. So there's our two-stager. It's being built, but our already long rocket is ready for the launch. So 3, 2, 1, and let's go. Beautiful. And it's an early morning launch, and it is, and look at the moon in the background. Isn't it glorious? Isn't it amazing? Yeah, if you, in case you were wondering, this is the rocket that you have seen in intro. Yes, it looks gorgeous. I just love sunrise when launching rockets. It's something surreal to it. And I hope that this probe will actually make it to the Kerbin above high so that we can gain that wonderful science. Yes, come on, get up there, you beautiful shiny rocket. Above 20, flying low, so I'm just waiting until the situation changes to flying high. There we go. And by the way, in case you were wondering, that mod is called Kerbal Engineer Redux. So yeah, it helps me to give me some extra telemetry and information, which will help me a lot. And look at this. We were able to submit all the science, which means we will have more cool things to unlock. So without no further ado, let's now accelerate the time as this probe starts to spin and spiral to its inevitable doom. Look at it go. Flippy, 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 and up and down it goes. Now, one thing that's kind of interesting with this rocket, when it was going down, it was like spinning like crazy, but after a while it stabilized, and take a look at this. Talk about flying body physics. I was initially thinking of I was gonna skip the part where it plummets to its doom, but look at this. It's flying, it's spin stabilized, and it's going on its merry way. It's saying bye-bye KSE, and thanks for the science, and I'm going off. And then it changed its mind and just decided to plummet right back into the coastal waters. Great. Look at that. We've managed to recover some science. We have 25, which means we can unlock the man technology. This will give us our first astronaut capsule or Kerbonaut capsule. So we might as well be designing something like that. And first of all, we want to do some experiments on the ground, meaning that like a very, very small experiment where basically Kerbal will observe his, you know, situation by sitting in a capsule. He'll try to figure out if this is cool, if he likes it, and also make some observation, ground experiments, take surface sample from the launch pad. I heard there's a lot of green goo down there. And yeah, okay, let's put in a couple of batteries so that maybe he can report his findings, a solar panel to keep him powered. Technically, a lot of this is a huge overkill, but I figured what the hell. Okay, so experiments, we wanna put those up in case we land on a separate biome, because this will be a small science hopper. Think of it like Star Hopper from, you know, SpaceX's testing from its early glorious days. So yeah, there we go. All right. Okay, let's queue it. When you press launch, here it adds queue to the build queue. Right. So, and now as we are building the capsule lander, our two-stager is ready for the flight. It's ready to go to space. Moon still being up in the heavens, and let's go. Look at it go, all spinny spinny. Very nice, actually. Now I'm pretty confident that this design will actually make it to space. Let me just rearrange a little bit my science-y thingies. Alright, so we have 20 meters per second and kicking up a new stage, and Yeah, for those with epilepsy, I do recommend you just wait a second until this probe gets somewhere, because it's about to get really shaky. Look at it go. Yeah, ultimately, it reached space. What do you know? Let's do the science. Transmitting, pressure scan, transmitted, and then the temperature, transmitted. Beautiful. Well, I'm pretty sure you already by now know what happens next. Yeah, it goes up, it goes down, and it plummets to its inevitable fiery doom. Yeah, there, by the way, guys, I'm wrapping it up, and if you like this video, fling it a like, and here in the top right corner, you will see my career Let's Play if you have missed it. Do check it out, it's kind of fun, and it's more of a career playthrough.